Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let us worship the Lord for a moment. Clapping the hands, we'll sing together that God may come into our midst. He may be filled with the power of Jesus. He is the only Savior. He is the only Redeemer. Let's thank and praise Him now today.
Wind of God, come and blow.
Oh Spirit of the Lord.
Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Let your power flow.
Let your power come down.
Steer our hearts, Brother of Life. Speak your word and we will rise.
Oh Holy
come
Spirit.
Come revive.
Come down, Holy
restore.
Spirit.
We can
fill us
live
with your
without
your
you,
power.
Lord.
Your strength.
Come and blow. Come and blow. Wind of God.
Oh, Spirit of the Lord. Touch and
wind
heal us.
Wind of God.
Cleanse us from all our
come and blow.
All the stains of
Holy
sin.
Spirit.
Even holiness.
Let your power flow.
Give us new inspiration. Pray, Lord.
Steer our hearts, Brother of Light. Speak your word and we will rise. Come revive.
Amen.
Come restore. We can live without you, Lord. Come and blow.
Holy Spirit
of God,
let all the chains be broken down
and blow. Holy Spirit of God,
the Holy Spirit come down. Let everyone be filled with happiness and joy. Let all the powers of darkness, let all the powers of evil be gone in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh Lord, give us joy and happiness. Give us your Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let your power flow.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Steer our hearts, Brother of Light. Speak your word and we will rise. Come restore. We can live without you, Lord. Come and blow. Come and blow. Wind of God. Almighty Father, we bless and thank you once again. Give us the power and courage to fight against the powers of darkness. Oh Lord, we want to live a life of holiness. We want to live like the free, with the freedom of a children of God. Help us, Lord. Give us your grace. Crush Satan under our feet. Mother Mary, you are the powerful person to crush Satan. And today we ask your grace, your intercession, your prayers, so that we may be able to overthrow Satan and his all crookedness, all his powers and tricks. This prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, today we should understand one fact that there is a power, there is a strong kingdom, there is a powerful person who is fighting against us, who
does not want us to be blessed by God? Who does not want our children to be blessed by God? Who wants the destruction of each and every one of us? Who wants all kinds of troubles in our families? Who wants us to get away from Jesus? Who wants us never to heed to the word of God? And such a power and such a kingdom is fighting against us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Power of this kingdom is none other than the kingdom of Satan or Satan himself. He is always against us. He always wants us to be put down. He wants his dominion to be over us. He wants us to completely depend on him instead of depending on God. So he makes a beautiful tactics. He makes so many things so beautifully well presented before us, so that we may be distracted and we may be disturbed and we may be distracted. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pope Francis said once, if a person who goes without knowing the tactics and without knowing the power of Satan, is like a person who does not understand the power and the might of the enemy who is going to attack you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just imagine a country is going to attack another country without knowing the military power and strength of the enemy. Then definitely they are going to be treated and they are going to be defeated. In the very same way, today many people say that Satan and the dominion of Satan is nonsense. There is no things such thing called as Satan. There is no kingdom for Satan. This is all utopian ideas. And many people say these are not true. But we know from the Bible itself that it is a fact that Jesus has cast out demons and he has promised that you too will do the same. He has told us you will crush Satan under your feet, and God has given the power and authority. So dear brothers and sisters, we know that there is a power fighting against us. A power, and Satan is always trying not to have victory for us. Therefore he is always trying to put us down. With regard to this, we have a beautiful Bible passage in the book of Daniel. Once Daniel wanted to know the future of his people. So what did he do? He tried to make a fasting and abstinence. What he did was, he avoided delicious food and he was taking some kind of fasting and penance, so that he may come to know the future of the people. What is the plan of God for these people? He wanted to know. And what is their future? In order to know this future, he is doing some kind of abstinence and prayer and fasting. Dear brothers and sisters, so this, we should note that this point, that when we are in a situation where we do not know where to move, or we don't know the future of our lives, of the future of our children, then what we have to do? We have to depend on God, and we should take some days of fasting and prayer, so that God ask the Lord, Lord, give us the knowledge, give us the future, or show us the way through which we have to go. And there is meaning for fasting and prayer and abstinence. These are not silly practices. We know in the old, many people used to practice, and in the modern world, many people neglect very easily. Try to have fasting, but you eat well. It is nothing. God doesn't expect this. Many people say like this, but not the truth. The truth is that even today, fasting and prayer has got its own value. And what he did? He avoided the delicious food and he was asking for God's plan for these people. And finally, what happened, you know? Finally, a messenger came from God to reveal the future of the people to Daniel. And the messenger says, Daniel, the beloved one, the very same day when you started your fasting and prayer, on the very same day, the prayer reached heaven. And I was sent to give you the message. But what happened, as I was coming to this place, the evil power of this area, this Persian area, he was just fighting with me. And finally, I handed over this man to Michael, the archangel, to fight with him, and I came here. Praise the Lord. This is what we see in the book of Daniel, chapter 10.
In the year of the reign of Cyrus, the king of Persia, God gave a message to Daniel, renamed Belteshazzar. This message spoke of fidelity, great anguish. Daniel paid attention to these words to the following vision. At that time, I, Daniel, was mourning for 3 weeks. I ate no rich food, took no meat or wine, and did not perfume myself for 3 weeks.
Praise the Lord.
See, praise the Lord.
For almost 3 weeks, 21 days, he was just fasting and praying. He did not take any meat, was making an abstinence and prayer. And finally, on the 21st day, what he saw is something different.
I raised my eyes and saw this: a man clothed in linen, with a belt of pure gold round his waist. His body was like chrysolite. His face had brilliance of lightning. His eyes were like blazing torches.
Praise the Lord. Now here he's explaining how this man was. He was such a powerful man, he couldn't even look up to his face. That was such a bright face he had. And so many things are said, you can read afterwards. And now, finally, when we come to the verse 11, we see the message is given to him. Let's listen to that.
He said to me, Daniel, man loved by God, pay attention to the words I shall say to you, and stand up, for I have been sent to you now. When I heard these words, I stood up trembling. Then he said to me, Daniel, do not be afraid. For from the first day when you sought to acquire understanding and to humble yourself before your God, your supplications were heard.
The first day when you started your prayer, the supplication was heard by God. And finally?
And it is precisely because of this that I have come. The prince of the Persian kingdom has resisted me for 21 days. But Michael, one of the leading angels, has come to my assistance. I left him there with the kings of Persia, and I have come to tell you what will happen to your people in the days to come.
Hallelujah. See, hallelujah. Here the word of God clearly says the prince of this area, which means the power of darkness, was just fighting against this messenger, and he said, I have handed over him to the archangel Michael, and he is just fighting with him, and I have come with this message to you, with the future, with regard to the future of this country, with regard to the future of these people. So dear brothers and sisters, we should know that there is always a fight against God's will, a fight against our people. Many are there, the powers of darkness is fighting against us. So therefore, what we have to do is, we have to pray before the Lord. Jesus said, rightly said, unless and until through prayer and fasting, you cannot get out of these evil powers. Praise the Lord. The satanic powers could be, you can fight against them only by prayer and fasting. Therefore I said, as we see in the Bible, we shall not be afraid of the satanic powers who is fighting against us. Because God has given the power and authority to crush Satan under our feet. That's what we see in the letter to Romans, chapter 16, verse 20. The word of God says,
the God of peace will soon crush Satan and place him under your feet.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So therefore,
by being a child of God, you shall not be afraid of anything, because God is with. He is very powerful. He is more powerful than Satan. Therefore, we have the power and authority to crush Satan under our feet. Again, in the letter of James, chapter 4, verse 7 and 8, we see the word of God says in this way:
Given then to God, resist the devil.
Resist the devil,
and he will flee from you.
And he will flee from you.
Again, draw close to God.
Draw close to God,
and he will come close to you.
And he will come close to you. So the word of God clearly says, what is the best methodology or the method to fight against Satan? Go close to God, draw near to God, and he will be near to you. And once God is near to you, have nothing to worry. You resist the devil and his plans and his tactics, then you will be able to face them with the power of God. Hallelujah.
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 The book of Genesis, again we see, well, chapter 4, verse 7. Genesis 4, 7, the word of God says, unless you do good things, Satan is just at the door. Praise the Lord. He's ready to attack you at any time. So make sure that you do good things. That's what we see in the book of Genesis, chapter 4, verse 7.
If you do right, why do you not look up? But if you are not doing what is right, sin is lurking at the door. It is striving to get you, but you must control it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the sin, the Satan, the devil is always trying to attack you. If you don't do good things, he's just standing in front of at the door. And therefore, dear brothers and sisters, the word of God says, we have to fight against this power so that we may become victorious. It is possible only by becoming closer to God, then we get the power to resist and to crush Satan under our feet. Praise the Lord. Let's stand. We ask the Lord. Lord, we need your prayer. We need your strength, Lord, because we are weak by ourselves. Oh Jesus, we need your power and we need your strength to resist the tactics that resist the power of Satan. And it is through your grace we can resist them. So give us the grace. Let us raise the hands up to heaven and praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Lord, give us the grace and power to curse Satan. Give us the power to draw closer to Jesus so that we may be more equipped with the spiritual powers and weapons so that we can crush under Satan. Your heart, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Breathe upon me, breath of God. Breathe upon me, Spirit of the Lord. As we lift our hands in surrender to your name, most high. Yielding to your Spirit, you walk in your
love. Help us, Lord. Give us the voice. Jesus, help us to fight against Satan and his
all. We adore
you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Your holy name.
Adore you, Jesus. Glorify
you. Holy
name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise and worship the Lord. Our mighty God is here with us. Hallelujah. Raising the hands up to heaven. Praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we praise and thank you. Lord, we need your blessings in abundance. We need your courage and strength. We need your deliverance in our lives. In the name of Jesus, let all the chains be broken down. Let all the powers of darkness be gone in Jesus' name.
Let us pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, there is power.
In the name of Jesus, there is power. In
the name of Jesus, there is deliverance, there is healing, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain.
Let every chain be broken down in Jesus' name.
To break
and the power of Jesus comes down to each and everyone who is watching this service. Oh Lord, all those who are attending in their own homes, in their own offices, when they be blessed in Jesus' name. And all the blessed be God in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name, let all the blocks, let all the problems, all the sickness be cured
in the name of Jesus.
Lord, let the grace come down, let the anointing increase, or let it be blessed, touched by the Holy Spirit.
To break every chain.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
To break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Let the power of Jesus come down on each and every one of us. Oh Lord, we worship and thank and glorify you, Lord. Raise the hands up to heaven. Now God is going to heal you. God is going to touch you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let there be a mighty healing in Jesus' name. Let there be a great anointing in Jesus' name. Let everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus' name, there is deliverance in Jesus' name. Let all the chains be broken down. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let's bow our hearts. Oh sacrament.
Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and in his saints. Amen.